Welcome back. If our next magician fools Penn and Teller, they'll be the second one tonight. Can the streak continue? Wish this next magician luck.
Hey, I'm Mentalist Brian Curry, and I'm going to Las Vegas to try to fool Penn and Teller. Did you get that? All right. I have the best fake job on the planet. People actually pay me to fly around the world and to pretend to read people's minds. But when COVID hit, I went from doing over 200 shows a year to being a stay-at-home dad. On the bright side, I got to spend so much time with my kids.
So many dad jokes.
But we made it.
We made it.
Now that life is getting back to normal, I have a show in DC called The Good Liar. Of course, in our nation's capital, I'll never be the best liar. Penn, Teller, I hope you're ready, because I'm coming for you. Kids, it's time to go.
Give it up for DC's most honest con man, Brian Curry.
I think everyone who watches this show knows that you guys are serious skeptics. And as a fake mind reader, I can think of nothing more gratifying than trying to turn you into true believers, true fake believers. Penn, would you mind joining me up on stage?
I'd be happy to.
How's it going?
Doing very well, thank you.
It's nice to meet you.
Very nice to meet you.
Now, you're a skeptic. Which means you don't believe in that mind-reading garbage.
No,
you
don't. I don't.
Horoscopes or fortune cookies or vaccinations.
Well, fortune
or
cookies. No, vaccinations and fortune cookies. I believe in both of those.
Yeah, I know. That joke was funnier a few years ago, though. Now, the Teller we see on TV, that's not the same Teller that you know.
That's correct.
You guys have been together a long time. Over, what, 40 years?
46 years, actually. 47 by the time this airs.
That's incredible. Your relationship's coming up on menopause, so congratulations.
Stuff like that, yeah.
Now, they say after 2 years, you start to develop a psychic bond, right? Mm-hmm. I bet there are times, Penn, without speaking, where Teller, you know exactly what Penn is thinking, right? I want you to take a second and think of all the words you would use to describe Teller.
Okay.
Now think of a TV-friendly word.
Okay.
Have you got one word?
Yes.
I'm gonna have you write that word down. Not that I don't trust
you. I'm not sure I can spell it. Maybe I should change it.
You wanna switch to another one?
Maybe I should. I think I can spell it.
You got it. I have an envelope, which you can't see through. Even if you could, inside of that envelope is another envelope, which you also can't see through. Inside of that's a card. Would you write your word big and bold, nice and clear?
I'm gonna write a word that I can spell.
Perfect.
Okay.
And we're not gonna look. Now tell her, if I'm being totally honest, I don't know if this is gonna work. I'm not a mind reader. I'm barely a mind user. Are we good, Penn?
Yes, we are.
Okay, I'll take the pen.
Okay.
Thank you. And I will take the card as well.
Okay.
Thank you, sir. Now, the truth is, when I'm off stage, I'm a skeptic. I'm like you guys. I'm like an attractive Penn. Now, if you could, I'm gonna place this envelope, goes in here. If you could face forward for me.
Okay.
Hold this up against your body.
Okay.
And in your mind, mentally count how many letters are in the word. Don't say it out loud, but in your mind, count how many letters are in the word.
Okay.
Got it. Yes or no? The word you wrote down is a three-letter word.
No.
No, but. But it does begin with three letters, is that correct?
Well, yes.
That's a hit. We're gonna call that a hit. Now, focus on the first letter of that word. Pardon me, I'm gonna come over here. I'm getting something all over my hands. Ew. Is it start with an S?
Yes, it does.
Ah, this is working. I can't believe it. Look, historically thinking's always been Teller's thing. You're doing so great. Now, I want you to face forward for me, because behind your head, I'm going to write the thought bubble. So that everyone can see exactly what you think about Teller. Now, let's be honest. You and I both know I'm not a real mind reader.
Mm-hmm.
So if the word that I just wrote down happens to match the word that you were thinking of, I'm not gonna use the word miracle, but I'd be okay if you did.
Okay.
What was the word?
Sneaky.
Sneaky?
Sneaky.
Totally.
Goodness gracious.
Thank you so much.
Goodness gracious, thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, goodness. Sneaky. He is and you are sneaky.
Brian Curry. So why did you decide to pick Penn for this routine?
Oh, so there's you.
on stage, and everyone, you're like the world's nicest human. I would hate someone for picking on you. And then there's Teller, but it seems ethically weird to like pick on somebody who can't defend themselves.
Oh, he can. You're from DC, you must play for some interesting people.
I do. I perform for celebrities, but DC celebrities. So we're not talking movie stars, we're talking politicians. So it's slightly different, but it's still fun.
So do you ever get nervous when you perform?
I'm terrified right now.
Really? But you're done performing.
I am done performing, but I'm excited. I'm here. I got to perform for millions of people in the same room as two of my favorite magicians. Oh. I'm talking to a famous actress. Oh. Like, I may not fool them, but it still feels like a win, you know?
Yeah. Let's see if Penn and Teller know the method to your magic.
Hey there, Brian.
Hey,
nice, how's it going? Nice being up there with you. Real funny guy, real good thing. Also, you do mentalism right. You know, we get disgusted by not just the obvious stuff, the fact that we're skeptics, people that claim to actually read minds don't interest us in any way. Not only is it morally wrong, it's also not interesting. You want to be funny while you're doing this. But also, a lot of mentalists go to so much trouble to use high-tech stuff, and they've got earpieces, and they've got little devices hidden on them, and they've got all sorts of hidden cameras and all sorts of iPhone stuff, and it just gets so tedious. And you did this the real old-fashioned way with skill, and you did sleight of hand, you know, some very clever stuff on top of all the clever stuff that people saw. But you know, you pointed out very clearly that Tell and I have been working together 47 years, and also the word that I chose was sneaky. And I have not spent 47 years next to someone sneaky to be fooled by someone else who's sneaky, who's also that close to me. So if you really had mind-reading powers, do you think you fooled us?
I didn't fool you. Aww. This was so much fun. Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Brian Curry! Teller get top billing on this show. We make them earn it by closing each show with a trick of their own. You don't want to miss it.